You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You would rather be riding your Norton, going fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. When your grammar school days were over, it was 1917, and you did the right and proper thing. You were just 18. You were never mentioned in dispatches. You never mentioned what you did or saw. You were just another keen young man in the mud and stink of war. And you were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You'd rather be singing the Pirate King or fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. And you came home from the Great War with the pips of a captain's rank and a German officer's Luger and no money in the bank. Your family sent you down the coal mine to learn to be captain there, but you didn't stand it very long. You needed the light in the air. Oh, you were never any good with money. Couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You would rather be watching the fulmers fly or fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. So when the Second War came along, you knew what should be done. You would re-enlist to teach young men the booby trap and the gun. And they sent you home to Yorkshire with a crew and a Lewis gun, so you could save your seaside town from the bombers of the Hun. And you were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You'd rather be finding the nightjar's nest or fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. When my mother came to your door with a baby in her arms and her big hurt boy just 9 years old trying to keep her from harm, if you had been a practical man, you would have been forewarned, and you would have seen that it never would work, and I would have never been born. There's no proper work in your seaside town, so we moved here looking for a job. You were storming at the power station just before I came along, and nobody talked about how you quit, but I know that's what you did. My mother said you were a selfish man, and I was your selfish kid. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. And your Norton, it was soon gone, along with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. You showed me Eyebright and the Hedgerow, Speedwell and Traveller's Joy. You showed me how to use my eyes when I was just a boy. And you taught me how to love a song, and all you knew of nature's ways. These are the greatest gifts I've ever known, and I use them every day. Oh, you were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Maybe not hard enough for the hard. You'd rather be riding your Norton, going fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. It's been a real pleasure to play for you. Thank you. Thank you.